Welcome back, everyone. This is Erik Malkavian as Jaze, the Nova Hot Deca in Shadowrun Returns. Remember, in our last exciting episode, we went to the Universal Brotherhood in order to confront Lady Jessica, Grandma Jessica Watts. Ran into a bug problem and got ran off, basically. But we did free a young lady named Marie Louise, so we did some good there. Coyote is eagerly waiting to talk to me, so let's do that before we go see Mr. Johnny Clean. Coyote's face is pale and voice is low, shaking. What was that back there, man? Just what the frick was that? Looks like the Brotherhood is transforming their followers into bugs. And Sam's sister's their leader. If I didn't see it, there's no way I'd believe it. Giant, unkillable bugs. She shudders, shakes it off. Fine, whatever. I want that woman dead now more than ever. If you go after her again, you think of me, okay? I'll be around, locked and loaded. Will do. Okay, later. Yep, we'll be taking her with us. Oh yes, we'll be taking Miss... Cherry. Hey there, Jaze. Johnny Clean asked me to flag you down the minute I saw you. He said he's got someone who wants to talk to you. You sound a little freaked out about it. He's waiting for you downstairs. Johnny Clean freaked out? Okay, I'll go talk to him, sweetheart. Thank you. No sweat. Jimmy Bartlett. Oh, man. Looking to hire the best of for some common rabble. Got a few questions. Wiz, what's on your mind? What's your story, bro? It's your usual classic story for the ages. Hometown boy does good. Joins an elite squad, and boom! Boom is a technical term for an explosion. Got blown up, got hurt real bad. And now I have these shiny legs. I'll do it all again. Obviously, I tried to miss the bomb part. Now, I'm here, running the best damn elite merc unit out there. What's the story behind the Nephilim network? Need to know, chummer. And you don't need to know. Okay. So how'd you get involved with the Seamstress unit? Oh, you know how it is. There's a girl, and a gun, and a back against the wall. You might say me, in this place, we were made for each other. Ain't gonna tell you more than that, homie. That's all I get then, I guess. Bye. Guess that story was lost to the shadow. Spine grass, I've got something I need to despise. Johnson, the man sizes you up as you approach. His carefully groomed hair and the shine on his shoes seems out of place for the Barons. Hey, you looking for work? We got a little something if you're up for it. It's a milk run. My experience, it's never a milk run. Grins. exposing a set of unnaturally white teeth. Don't worry, this one is straightforward as they come. Job's a simple extraction. The people I represent are interested in acquiring the talents of a scientist named Sada. Unfortunately, Mr. Sada is currently engaged with Renraku. Which means he's engaged for life. That doesn't sit well with the people I represent. They see it as a subversion of the free market. So you want me to secure Mr. Sada's freedom to work for your people instead? Flash his pearly whites again. Exactly. But it has to be now. Renraku is shipping Sada out of Seattle in the morning with some sort of overseas research project, I don't know. Tonight he's being kept at a hidden research facility out here in the Barrens, just a couple miles from here. Here they've been bringing in unmarked shipments for weeks now, thinking that nobody notices. We don't care about any of that. We just want Sada before he gets out of our reach. Place should be lightly guarded, probably rent-a-cops. Get in, grab Sada, and get out in exchange of authorized permit, 9,000 yen. I am not, however, authorized to negotiate. All right, think about it, man. I've got to go downstairs. You say so, remember. Step out that door and the job's gone. Alright, sure. I'll come find you if I change my mind. Bobby. Yo, guy, have we met? You look familiar. Need a lot of people, no problem. Need some brain benders tonight? Yeah, I saw you on the street. Got some of that merc stuff, freakers, taxi drivers, you know. See what you got. Yeah. Got more than enough of that stuff. Hello, stranger. I'm busy right now, so I hope you've got something that's worth my time. How about a list of every politician the Universal Brotherhood has bribed to date? I could certainly find someone interested in that information. We'll take some lead work to verify the veracity of such a list. How about 200? This info is about to be worth a lot more in the next few days using my Shadowrun engine. And what am I supposed to do? Take your word for it? Makes eye contact, hesitates. Fine. I'll speculate, but only because I can find you if this doesn't pan out. 2500, no more.
Jaze?
Battered, bruised, but not yet beaten. I heard you made trouble with the Universal Brotherhood. Just following through on a promise I started, but I aim to finish. People are saying, and starting to say, that there's dark threat going down in those chapter houses. Like, they're taking advantage of the poor folk who go there looking for help. I got to say, that makes my blood boil.
labels. Half the population is probationary citizens. We don't need more people preying on the most defenseless members of society. And I hate to be race into it, but it's a fact that a good number of people who go to the Brotherhood for help are metals like myself. But what options do we have? Do you realize that it would take an act of Congress to grant me full citizenship? And they have yet to do it once. Wars are started more easily than a meta get a sin in this country. So it's no wonder we turn to people like the Brotherhood, who claim to listen to our woes and speak out on our behalf. He catches himself, takes a breath, and visibly calms. Sorry, I just knew some folk who went to the Brotherhood for these very reasons. I might have ended up there myself if Mrs. Kabuta hadn't taken me here. Whatever's going on in there, I trust you put an end to it one way or another. And count on it. Get him, sir. Let me check my inventory. I have a Renmaku craftwork. Play some music. Once, Dr. Castle is not utterly absorbed in her work. In fact, she seems to have set aside whatever she's doing to give you her full attention. Perhaps word has spread about what you've already faced and what is still to come. I'm glad to see you're all right, Jaze. I was afraid they'd be carting you back to me in pieces. I don't suppose it would do me any good to suggest an early retirement, or at the very least, that you might delay whatever is coming long enough for you to get a decent night's sleep and a full meal. I never knew you cared, Doc. Who said I do? A good cast like Kyle like you only comes around every so often. You're no good to me yet. Oh, who am I kidding? I know your type all too well. Words of caution have little worth, and words of prohibition only make you eager to throw yourself into the fire. You're like children that way. So fine, do what you will, just tell me what I can do to keep you alive that much longer. So what have you heard, Doc? Well, let's review it. In the past few days, I've lost one patient, and nearly lost a second. I've also learned that a man claiming to be a fellow doctor was responsible for the first of those deaths. Yeah, the doctor. And now I hear that another supposed force for good has been committing heinous acts on innocent men and women. Quite frankly, it's almost enough to make a woman give up on a whole human race. But then I remember why I don't. I remember how many innocent lives Mrs. Kabuta has saved by giving them a place and purpose here at the Union. I remember seemingly useless wastes of flesh like Paco, risking their lives to save the ones they love. I remember that some people are still willing to stand up against those who seek to do harm to others. And that's the real reason you won't hear me argue against your choice. Because I agreed that it must be done. I only hope it can be done without any more innocents coming to harm. That's the plan, Doc. I appreciate the lie. I'd like to wake up to a world short one less evil, though. Now, how can I help make that happen? See, your medical supplies is all I can afford. That's it. I got a ton of stuff to sell. Might as well sell this right here. Well, this came in handy. Golly. Got something? Or just taking one last browse through my stock? Best be prepared, best safe than sorry. Measure twice, cut once, and 100 of the truck sayings seem woefully inadequate under these circumstances. But what shall it be? Boy. Okay. Alright, Johnny. Johnny's hunched over his deck, idly fiddling with the cyber deck. He seems preoccupied, looks up when you approach, eyes narrow. Been making new friends out there? Could be. And yeah, some guy named Baron Samedi wants to talk to me in the Matrix. Sounds like you two have already met then. Frowns. Well, this Baron, he's been asking about you on Shadowland. Strange guy. Has a pretty distinctive icon. Skull face with a top hat. Can't tell what he wants, but the guy seems pretty serious. I wouldn't ignore this if I were you. Deckers have a way of making people's lives miserable if they're so inclined. This Baron character, what do you know about him? Johnny Janitor persona is gone, replaced by something colder, more dangerous. A did some checking. Didn't get much because he's new on the scene. He's no Wilson, though. Got a rep as a direct hot wire boy from what I hear. Never rides along with physical entry teams, though. Purely remote work. Samedi, like the voodoo spirit? Yeah, that's the one. Sits at the crossroads of the living and the dead. Never heard of a spirit in the Matrix. Been around a long time. I've seen a lot of avatars running the tricks. A lot of them. You ask me? It's just some guy trying to look scary to make a name for himself. Think of it as personal branding. How long has he been looking for me? He's been spamming Shadowland for the last hour. I'd say he's new on the scene for what everyone's talked about him. Even the hottest deckers like Dodger are saying he's a force to be reckoned with. He's not the patient type. Something I should know? Could be. I'll tell you after I talk to him. And what's Shadowland? That's where the shadow community goes to talk about anything. Shadowing. Who's planning what projects, who's hiring, which corp is screwing which, anything that affects Shadowrunners, and how they make money. It's where I'd go to see if I could pick up any dirt about you. Know anything about giant, magic, indestructible bugs? Is that a joke? No. Saw one underneath the Universal Brotherhood an hour ago. Bigger than a damn troll. You mean indestructible? As in, I couldn't kill it. Whatever you've gotten into, Jaze, you're in it deep. What I hear, the Brotherhood has members in high places. Government, courts, law enforcement. Be careful, chummer. Enough talk. You talk to the Baron. Okay, you can use my secure jack point. Or set up a portal to Shadowlands. Feel free to jack in whenever you're ready. Alright, let's go ahead and check in. Now, bonsoir, mon ami. Samedi is pleased that we can have a private conversation. Everyone on Shadowland knows you're looking for me. Why the spam? Samedi wishes to thank you for saving Marie Louise from the Universal Brotherhood. The girl is quite precious. If harm were to come to her, he does not know what he would do. He also offers you his help. The insects you encountered, they are something, no, yes, something too dark. To ignore them would be folly. There's much at stake. Samedi knows you're after this woman, Jessica Watts. For your own reasons, he can help you get to this woman and defeat her bug. And hypothetically, how would we do that? The job will not be simple, nor will it be straightforward. But Samedi can guarantee it will be dangerous. Telestrian Industries has been working for 2 years on a formula, codename Aegis. They are working with another corporation, a foreign corporation, to refine it. this is their third attempt to get it right, and they believe they have. Manufacturing began several months ago. Unfortunately, their manufacturing plant in the Columbia Valley was recently blown up. Could have been corporate espionage, or it could have been something else. This is unknown. What is known is that a large sample of this formula survived. Okay. So what does this have to do with Jessica and the Universal Brotherhood? We want Aegis because it kills bugs. Big ones, like the ones you met at the Universal Brotherhood. If you want to go back there and bring the Watts woman to justice, you'll need Aegis. And as it happens, Samedi knows where the last sample of Aegis is being kept. Hence the job at hand. We are going to break into the Strange Industries primary operations office complex here in Seattle. Aegis will be somewhere within that building. We will find the Aegis sample and liberate it for ourselves. Why not just let Telestrian take care of it? Sounds like they're already halfway there. Telestrian, do not talk to me, Telestrian. He's an executive, a businessman. Do you know what his reaction was when he learned of the insect threat? He called a meeting. He and his associates will be debating action forever. So, will you do this thing? Will you ally with Baron Samedi? Got more questions first. The Baron understands the need for information all too well. Ask what you will. And how do you know all this about Aegis? Because Samedi has personal connections into James Telestrian's affairs. You see, he knows. I want to know more about you first, though. Who are you, really? What is there to know? Baron Samedi is gifted, you see. He was born to walk. He was born to travel the Matrix, bending it to his will. Who's Baron Samedi, really? What is the difference? When a clown removes his paint, he is still a clown, but in disguise. It is only when he's painted that people applaud. You never explained to me how you and Marie-Louise know each other. That is true. And it is for her to say, not Samedi. He has nothing to lose while she... We must ask her. Well, I know who Marie-Louise Telestrian is. And I know who her aunt Lynn Telestrian is. And who her father James Telestrian is. Now, I don't see any of these questions here. But that's who she is. Okay, so anyway, but besides that, I'm done asking questions. And are you convinced? Okay. I'm in. Jessica's going to pay for what she's done. Ah, yes, revenge is a very motivating thing. Let's something Samedi knows about. Yes, he does. Woo! Samedi will be part of this evening's events, but must remain remote. He will keep all of Seattle law enforcement and off-duty Telestrian security away while you locate the information we need from inside. And how do I get inside? Well, that's a silly question. What about the on-duty Telestrians? Once you shoot me, well, I'll take care of those guys. How do I get inside? Ah, the Baron will handle that as well. Telestrian guards will be rerouted throughout the building. With the right timing, no one will even know you're there. But of course, even Baron Samedi can't anticipate all possibilities. Till tonight, you must use your contacts to hire a team and travel to the Telestrian office complex downtown. You'll be contacted again when we have gained entrance. So jack out. I'm not going to be able to take that job from Mr. Johnson. Telestrian Industries. Hit the big times, chummer. You need a second decker, might as well take care of the best. No way I can buy one? I'm not gonna say that. That means you, right? No, not inside man anymore. My running days are over. Here's the elf who owes me a favor. He goes by Dodger. You may have heard of him. He's one of the best deckers in Seattle. And this is me saying it. I'll get you his contact information. You'll know him by the way he talks. Like he's a damn Charles Dickens novel. I don't really need a decker, man. I'm a decker. Okay. So, on to Mr. Delilah. I mean, I'm a decker. That's what I got my back. I mean, if you had a gun for hire, that would be lovely. Yeah. I mean, my decking skills are already at 5. Do some research and I will be right back. the shaman inspired such case. A chill visibly runs through me. Please, let's speak of more pleasant things. Perhaps commerce? Nothing.
Definitely the right person.
I'd love to splurge on some cyberware, but I can't do it. We will be back shortly. Boy, that one job is still waiting us 9,000 yen.